First, we are going to make a candy bar or stick using just one balloon. You have to inflate balloon leaving about 3-inch flat tail. Then we will make the candy bar using 2 or 3 balloons. At the end, we will make an arch using a chain of candy bars. So let's twist a chain of 2 6-inch bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 2 bubbles in one lock twist. Now we lock all ends of the first 2 bubbles in one lock twist. Now I'm going to fold the balloon to estimate the size of the next bubble. It should be about 1/3 of the rest of the balloon. Twist the third 10-inch bubble. Twist the fourth 6-inch bubble. Twist the fifth 6-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. Lock all ends of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 6th bubble. It should be the same size as the 3rd bubble. Now we just lock both ends of the chain of the first 6 bubbles in one lock twist. We can use the rest of the balloon as a handle, or just cut it off and tie off the end. Now we wave or braid the 3rd and the 6th bubbles around each other. Just like that. We made one balloon candy bar. We made the top and the bottom of the candy bar look exactly the same. Usually I use the one balloon candy bar as a body for animals or cartoon characters. For example, I will attach a bunny head, I made it previously, to the candy bar. This is the bunny head. We have to twist 2-inch bubble to make the neck, and then we lock the free end of the neck bubble between the 4th and the 5th bubbles of the candy bar. We can cut off the rest of the white balloon, or we can use it to make our candy bar more colorful. We have to twist one more white bubble, the same size as the 3rd or the 6th blue bubbles. Then we lock the free end of the last white bubble between the 1st and the 2nd blue bubbles. Now we braid or wave the white bubble between the 3rd and the 6th blue bubbles. The candy bar looks very much as the penguin body. Little touch here and there, we have to fix all bubbles in the proper position, adjust them properly. Once again, we made one balloon candy bar. There are much more we can make using 2 or 3 different color balloons. That's a back view on our bunny candy bar. Let's put it away for now and make 2 balloons candy bar. Inflate 2 different color balloons leaving up to 2-inch flat tails. We have to tie nozzles of both balloons in one knot. There is nothing fancy, just a regular knot. Fold the balloons together and hold them in one hand at the point where you want to twist the first 6-inch bubble. Twist both balloons at the same time. We made the first pink and the first blue bubble. Lock both ends of the first bubbles in one lock twist. Now we have to braid or wave both balloons around each other. There are different ways to braid or wave. I believe I showed it before in some instructions. Anyway, let's do it together again. Basically, I put my left hand between balloons. I hold one balloon with my fingers and another balloon I hold with my thumb. I turn both balloons at the same time with my right hand. Keep your hands close to each other to make small even steps. We twist the second bubble 6 inches away from the end of the shortest balloon. There is usually one balloon shorter than another one. Now we twist the third 6 inch bubbles. We have to tie and lock both ends of the third bubbles together in one lock twist. We're making the top and the bottom of our sculpture exactly the same, in the same fashion. As you can see in my sculpture, the blue balloon is a bit longer than the pink. So I have to cut off the rest of the blue balloon and tie off the end. Trim the ends or just hide it between bubbles. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations! We have made the two balloons candy bar. Now we are going to attach one more balloon to this sculpture. Inflate the third balloon, leaving up to 2 inch, as we did the first two balloons. We have to attach the nozzle of the third balloon between bubbles at the bottom or the top of our sculpture. Both sides look exactly the same, so it really doesn't matter where we're going to attach it. What actually is matter is to twist all bubbles of the third balloon exactly the same size as we did the first balloons. So we twist the first green 6 inch bubble and lock both ends of the green bubble in one lock twist. The next step is a little tricky. It may not work properly if we just wrap the green balloon around the candy bar. I'm doing it right now just for example. It looks like the third balloon is shorter than the first two balloons. That's a little trick we were talking about. I wave the third balloon around the candy bar, slightly forcing it in waves of the candy bar. Now we twist the second green bubble and lock the end. We twist the third green 6 inch bubble, lock both ends of the third bubble in one lock twist, cut off the rest of the green balloon, tie off the end, trim the ends, hide them between the bubbles, fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations, we have made the 3 balloons candy bar. Once again, we can use the candy bar as a body for animals and cartoon characters. We can connect both ends of one candy bar to make a head. We can connect number of candy bars to each other to make large size sculptures like chains, arches and so on and so on. The 3 balloons candy bar is quite solid and sturdy. We can use it to make poles to support other sculptures. As opposite to it, the 2 balloons candy bar is much lighter and flexible. So let's take a look. Here's our 1 balloon candy bar and this is 3 balloons candy bar. Alright, let's make a couple of simple 2 balloons candy bars. We will use them to make a chain or an arch. Inflate all balloons leaving up to 1 inch flat tail. Tie nozzles of 2 balloons in one knot. We are not going to twist any bubbles. We will use entire balloons just to wave them around each other. We braid or wave the 2 balloons up to the flat tails. At the end, we have to make sure that both balloons are of the same size. If there is more than 1 inch difference in size of balloons, then we have to twist a bubble to make the balloons even. And then we tie the flat tails of both balloons in one knot. Fix the end of balloons nicely. We made the simplest two balloons candy bar. Make the second candy bar exactly the same. I have made it in advance. So now we tie ends of two candy bars together in one knot. You can tie a regular knot or something very fancy, it's all up to you. It's always good to have someone to assist you, and especially when we work with large sculptures. Assistant can save you a lot of time by inflating balloons and save your sculpture from disaster just by holding the other end of the sculpture when you twist the balloons or moving it around somehow. Okay, we have made the first link. It will look much better if we cover the connection spot with some decoration. A flower will do perfect. I'm going to use a 6-petals flower. I made it in advance. We can use any flowers, 3, 4, 5 petals. It doesn't make big difference. So I just force the flower bubbles between candy bars. We can place both candy bars on one side of the flower, just like this, for example. In the same fashion, we can attach more candy bars to the same flower. I'm going to place the candy bars on opposite side of the flower. Basically, we double the size of our sculpture. We can add more candy bars to our sculpture. Right now we have about 6 feet, I think. Once again, we use 2 balloons candy bars for our sculpture, so it's quite flexible. Using 3 balloons candy bars for our sculpture would add stiffness. That is what you have to do if you need your arch to be rigid, firm. There are so many possibilities to use it for decoration. You can actually give it a circle shape if you want. Alright, let's go back to the twisting. So far we were waving balloons in one direction only. Often we want to make symmetrical or mirror reflections of our sculptures. Let's twist in opposite directions, this way. So I basically put left index finger between balloons, my left hand facing me, and then I wave the balloons around each other in opposite direction. At the end, we have to make sure the balloons have the same length. So here I have to twist the third pink bubble at the very end. Tie the flat tails of both balloons together in one knot. Cut off the third pink bubble. Finish the waving at the end of balloons. Now let's see what we have made so far. The first two candy bars we twist in one direction, it's on my left hand. And the third, the last candy bar we twist in opposite directions, it's on my right. Let's make a pair of candy bars waved in opposite direction. I prepare the candy bar in advance. So now I just attach them together. Then I'm going to use a flower to cover the connection. the flour. We are going to use our candy bars to make an arch. I use sticky tape and proper color thread to attach the arch to walls and ceiling. The sticky tape may not work on all floors. In this case, I would fill up a couple of empty flat balloons with rice or sugar, salt, whatever is available in your household. Tie up the balloons and attach them to the bottom of our arch. Okay, now we have to connect both sides of the arch. This connection is the top of the arch. We can use flowers or whatever you think is best to cover the top connection. Our arch has two poles only. It is quite simple. We can add more poles to the sculpture. Basically, we can use the arch as a pattern to make a dollhouse. It would take many more balloons and a lot of your time, but it's fun. Talking about fun reminds me that we can use water balloons as a load for the bottom of our sculptures. Here's a four petals flower that I'm going to use to cover the top connection. Again, we can keep both candy bars on one side of the flower or on the opposite sides. It all depends how you want to arrange the sculpture. This is a large size sculpture. The bottom part of my arch already lying on the floor, and shuffling it around the floor would make the balloons pop. That's why you wish you have an assistant to hold the balloons. I just keep fixing the balloons, the flower bubbles, in different positions to give you ideas how it could work on your arch. I am very sure by now you have many ideas what you can do with the candy bar. Let's shortly go over what we have done. We use two balloons candy bars to make one arch. We learned to wave balloons in different directions. We made one balloon candy bar, we made two balloons candy bar, and we made three balloons candy bar. We use a candy bar as a body for an animal. So here's our arch. Here is three balloons candy bar. I don't have an assistant here. Alright, let me drop it. Here's a bunny with one balloon candy bar instead of the body. In next instruction, we will make arch and many more other things using different technique. Have fun and happy twisting!